Hey everyone, I made something new. Not really a purpose for this one. I'll just show you what it does. It's just a portable speaker that I got at the Dollar Tree. Power on, push the button. It makes a sound. You turn this, push the button, makes a different sound. Yeah, it doesn't really do anything other than that. It runs on two AAA batteries. And yeah, I'll show you what's in it. You could probably just skip ahead in the video if you want. A little lazy, probably not gonna edit this out. Screws. I'll put those in my lens cap for now. So, I mean, it's an incredibly simple circuit. I just tapped into the board, the audio amplifier. That's all this is. It's just an audio amplifier. You have your audio input here. Actually, we'll zoom in. So I have the audio input here, and I just added a 555 circuit to it, as you can see in here. It's wedged down inside here. Nice compact circuit. Probably can make it smaller. I'll give you the schematic on that later. So the output of the chip of the 555 pin 3 just goes into the audio input here. Since this is mono, audio outputs for these have two connections. This only utilizes one because there's one speaker. It's mono. So just find which one is the input. You'll see three connections. One is ground. One of them is open, doesn't go anywhere. That's this one, and then the third one is the money one. That's the one you want. So the circuit, the whole thing is powered by roughly 3 volts. The 555 requires, I think it's 5 volts to 15. I run them at 10 to 12, so I had to add a voltage booster to it, you know, give it enough electrons to chooch, right? So there's the voltage booster right there. It's actually the same one. It's just one of these. It's not the XL6009, it's the next one, smaller. I bought a lot of these, just a DC-DC converter. I bought a lot of these and about 1 in 3 don't work. So just random tip. And then I have a trim pot for changing the frequency, the duty cycle of the chip. Actually, the frequency of the chip, 555. So, here's the schematic. Let me get my camera set here. There we go. So the capacitor, I'm using a 2.2 nanofarad cap here. Pin 5, I'm leaving open. I think use that for a reference voltage. Some stuff I use it in, but this one I am not. It's out of simplicity. R1, it's a 10K resistor. R2, it's a 1 mega ohm trim pot. But I usually use I put in series a 10K with it also, just so when the trim pot's turned all the way over one way, it doesn't short between 6 and 7, pin 6 and 7. So it's a 10K and a 1 mega ohm. You can do whichever. Yeah, pretty simple. I mean, I have other plans for this stupid thing. But I'll save that for another video. So it comes in this box. I mean, there it is. I've used the speaker out of this one for another project. Fuck it, I'm not gonna open it. But that's what they come in. They're a dollar, just add a 555 to it. If you want to make it really interesting, you can add a 556 to it and have one output running into the input of the other. And then you can get one of them, the first one will generate a constant wave tone, just a constant tone, which you can vary. And the other one, you can change it to where it's intermittent, like a beep, like on, off, on, off. You know, you can change the timing of it. And then there's two trim pots you can add to that to vary the frequencies of both. I mean, it's basically this circuit just with another one attached to it. Yeah, I have a few ideas for how I want to modify this, change a few things. So if I decide to make part two, stay tuned for that. I'll leave it like this. Thanks for watching.